Miss Universe 1983. Arriving by boat down there on the Miami River, an 81 beautiful young woman headed for the magnificent new Miami Convention Center, where my successor will be chosen.
Well, my friend, the time has come. Raise the roof and have some fun. This pageant night has now begun. Let the music play on.
Play on, play on.
Everybody dance, everybody sing. Everybody start to swing. Come join our party, pageant,
fiesta,
whatever.
New Zealand's beautiful Lorraine Dowd. The international singing superstar, Tom Jones. Our hostess from the hit CBS series, Knots Landing, Joan Van Ark. Celebrated television personality and star of The Price is Right, Bob Barker. Gentlemen, here again is our host for this evening, Bob Barker.
Good evening. Just as athletes from around the world will travel to Los Angeles for the Olympics, and tourists from all over the world are traveling to New Orleans for the World's Fair, so too have beautiful young women from all over the world traveled to Miami for tonight's Miss Universe pageant. The international panel of celebrity judges will decide which of our 81 young ladies will be crowned tonight as the 33rd Miss Universe. During the next 2 hours, we'll be telling you how judges will select our winner, as well as more about our pageant in Miami, and of course, about our contestants. But first things first. So let's meet some of the world's most beautiful women wearing their national costumes in the traditional Miss Universe Parade of Nations. Miss Argentina.
Buenas noches. Mi nombre es Leila Hidar y vengo de Argentina. Gracias.
I am Jacqueline Pemberton. I'm calling from San Nicolas, Aruba.
I'm Donna Rudrum from Tasmania, Australia.
I'm Michaela Nussbaumer von Vorarlberg, Austria. I'm Lisa Worm from Christchurch, Barbados.
I'm Brigitte Nason from Antwerp, Belgium.
I'm Lisa Ramirez from Belize City, Belize.
I'm Randy Wilkinson from St. George, Bermuda.
I am Elizabeth Aponte and I'm from La Paz, Bolivia.
I'm Annelisa Flores. I came from São Paulo, Brazil. Thank you.
I'm Donna Patrice Fred from Tortola, British Virgin Islands.
I'm Cynthia Curler from Edmonton, Alberta, Canada.
I'm Dora Crichton from the beautiful Cayman Islands.
My name is Carol Benquio Muñoz. I come from Villa del Mar, Chile.
I'm Susana Caldas and I come from Cartagena, Colombia.
I'm Margaret Brown from the Cook Islands.
Mi nombre es Silvia Portilla y vengo de San José, Costa Rica.
I'm Suzanne Maria Fabrejo from Curaçao.
I'm Jasmine Mulavis from Limassol, Cyprus.
I'm Catalina Klaufen from Denmark, Copenhagen.
Mi nombre es Sumaya Heinzen, vengo de Puerto Plata, República Dominicana.
I'm Leonor Gonzen Banay, come from Guayaquil, Ecuador.
I am Lorena Samayo and I come from El Salvador.
I'm Louise Gray from Chesterfield in England.
I'm Annalise Pilus from Helsinki, Finland.
I am Mathieu Robin from Paris, France.
I am Mirabel Carrier from Banjul, the Gambia.
I'm Brigitte Berg from Mönchengladbach in Germany.
I am Jessica Palau from the Rock of Gibraltar.
I'm Becky Dogani, I'm from Athens, Greece.
I'm Martin Serem from Guadeloupe.
I'm Eleanor Beneventi Maga from Delhi, Guam.
I am Julieta Rudin, I come from Guatemala.
I'm Rosemary Nicole, I come from French Guiana.
I'm Nancy from Amsterdam, Holland.
I'm Myrtis Hyde, I come from the beautiful Bay Islands in Honduras. Thank you.
I'm Mina Godensi, I come from Hong Kong.
I'm Bertin Johansson from Reykjavik, Iceland.
Namaste, I'm Juhi Chawla from Bombay, India.
I'm Trish Nolan from Dublin, Ireland.
I'm Sapir Kaufman, and I come from Petah Tikva, Israel.
I'm Raffaella Baracchi and I come from Torino, Italy.
I'm Megumi Miyama, come from Tokyo, Japan.
안녕하세요, 임미숙이에요. I'm from Seoul, Korea.
I'm Sausa El Sayed, I come from Tripoli, Lebanon.
I'm Romain Bayal from Luxembourg.
I am Latifa Hamid, I come from Kuala Lumpur, Malaysia.
I'm Marisa Salmoud from Slima in Malta.
I am Daniel Thierry from Port-au-Prince in Martinique.
Soy Elizabeth Broden y vengo de México.
I'm Peter Harley Peters from Vinto in Namibia.
Kia ora, I'm Tania Clegg from Auckland, New Zealand.
I am Portia Salas from the Northern Mariana.
I'm Ingrid Marie Martins from Oslo, Norway.
Soy Celina Prada y vengo de Panamá.
I'm Patricia Marissa from Port Moresby, Papua New Guinea.
My name is Elena Ortiz Alegretti. I come from Asunción, Paraguay.
Soy Fiorella Ferrari de Lima, Peru.
I'm Maria Desiree Verdadero from Manila, Philippines.
I'm Joanna Kanska and I come from Poland.
I am Fatima Julia. I come from Lisbon, Portugal.
I'm Sandra Bosham. I come from the island of the Sun, Puerto Rico.
From Réunion.
I'm Mae Monaghan from Glasgow, Scotland. Thank you.
I'm Violet Lee Hui Min and I bring you warm greetings from Singapore.
I'm Letitia Sneyman, representing the Republic of South Africa.
Soy Garbiña Basole, representa España. Gracias.
I'm Yvonne Reading from Eskilstuna, Sweden.
I'm Sylvia Arpolder and I'm happy to bring you greetings from Switzerland.
My name is Savani Pagarnang and I'm proudly representing Bangkok, Thailand.
I'm Gina Cardia from Port of Spain, Trinidad.
I'm Gülçin Ülker, I come from Istanbul, Turkey.
I'm Deborah from the beautiful Texan, Caicos Island.
Mi nombre es Isa Pronsati, represento Montevideo, Uruguay. Gracias.
I'm Mae Shanley from Alamogordo, New Mexico, USA.
Patricia Maria Graham from Frederickstead, St. Croix, U.S. Virgin Islands.
I'm Carmen Maria Montiel and I come from Maracaibo, Venezuela.
I'm Jane Riley from Newport in Wales. Thank you.
I'm Lena Slade from the beautiful island of Western Samoa.
I'm Ksenia Borovic and I come from Zagreb, Yugoslavia.
I am Luka Ngewali from Finchester,
Zaid.
You've met our contestants, so now you are unofficial judges there at home and here in the theater can start making your choices to see if you agree with our celebrity panel selection of the new Miss Universe. One beautiful young woman who has the complete endorsement of our official and unofficial judges, as well as everyone connected with the pageant, is our hostess, Joan Van Ark.
You, Bob? I don't know what people ask you, Bob, but they always ask me afterwards, are we really excited at each pageant? And I've got to say, with tonight's international competition and all this great entertainment, well, that guarantees excitement. And after all, you know, we are live.
That's right. When CBS broadcasts Knots Landing or The Price is Right, Joan and I sit back and watch just as you're doing. But right now, you're there, and we're here, and nobody knows who the new Miss Universe will be. We can't tell you who will be chosen because we don't know at this point. But we can tell you how the selection will be made. And Joan's going to do that right now, aren't you?
Thank you, Bob. I certainly am. Each member of our panel of celebrity judges right over there will cast their votes for each one of our contestants in three categories tonight, which is swimsuits, evening gowns, and personal interviews, using a terminal like this one right here. Each judge will enter a score into our computer, anything from, say, a 1 to a 9.99. The computer then tabulates an average composite score for each candidate in each category. Now, I'm going to be with you throughout the evening. I'm going to be recapping the scoring. I'll be telling you some of the things about the pageant and talking with some of the people who are here tonight. And, of course, like you, trying to guess who our winner will be. So what do you say? Let's get started, huh? First up, there's a very special swimsuit fashion segment coming your way after this word from Folgers Crystals. Our judges right here began their evaluations a week ago and have completed preliminary judging. In just a few moments, we're going to know which 10 of our international beauties will be our semifinalists. You're looking now at the preliminary swimsuit competition, which was held on this stage last week under competitive conditions and with all the young ladies wearing identical competition swimsuits. But what you're about to see now is a special fashion swimsuit segment. A panorama of different Miami area locations serve as our background while our contestants show us their Miss Universe fashion swimsuits, especially designed by Catalina. And by the way, during this segment, our home audience will see the scores that each contestant received in the preliminary swimsuit competition. And those scores, like the others you'll see on your home screens this evening, will not be seen by our contestants, our judges behind me, or the audience right here with me in the theater. That's just for us. Okay, Bob?
Thank you, Joan. You judges at home have got another chance to look at our contestants and either change or reinforce your opinions during this fashion segment.
Don't be afraid to try the greatest sport around.
We move from the waters of Biscayne Bay, look at the ever-growing Miami skyline, and zero in on the pool at the new Pavillon Hotel, where our first group of young ladies enjoy some sun and games. The game is backgammon for Mina Godenzi, Miss Hong Kong, and Miss Dominican Republic, Sumaya Heinsen. Checking up on their checkers are a couple of lovely Europeans, Miss Germany, Regita Berks, and Raffaella Baracchi, Miss Italy. Queens protect their queens in a chess match between Michela Nussbaumer, Miss Austria, and Miss Lebanon, Sasan El Sayed. Asia meets Latin America across a Parcheesi board as Emmy Suk, Miss Korea, plays against Leila Adair, who is Miss Argentina. And moving to a table near a fountain, the name of the game is Gin Rummy. And the names of the players are Peggy Dogani, Miss Greece, and Sandra Beauchamp, Miss Puerto Rico. From poolside to oceanside, where the waters of the Atlantic meet Miami Beach. And we meet another group of lovely contestants on a boardwalk. We begin with Miss Gibraltar, Jessica Palau, and Miss Namibia, Peta Harley Peters. Soft surf and white sands provide a background for Marisa Samut, Miss Malta, and Nancy Nada, Miss Holland. Lounging here are Romain Bayel, Miss Luxembourg, and Deborah Lindsay, Miss Turks and Caicos. Bold Stripes become Portia Salas, Miss Northern Marianas. From the Alps and South Pacific come Sylvia Affolter, Miss Switzerland, and Miss Papua New Guinea, Patricia Marisa. Still in Miami Beach, we move from the ocean back to the poolside, this time at the Alexander Hotel. This looks like a life fit for a queen or a Miss Universe, just lying in the sun next to a pool, listening to a waterfall. It certainly seems to agree with Rulchen Ulker, who is Miss Turkey. And Miss Belize, Lisa Ramirez. Ice water by a waterfall hits the spot for Tanya Clegg, Miss New Zealand, and Sapir Kaufman, who is Miss Israel. Before they settle down for serious sunbathing, we get to see the white and blue swimsuits of Miss Philippines, Desiree Verdadero, and Lisa Worm, Miss Barbados. A beach ball, a waterfall, and pretty ladies. In this case, Miss Panama, Celina Prada, and Leticia Sneyman, Miss South Africa. Next stop, Coconut Grove and the marina at Monte Trainer's Restaurant, where a group of young ladies enjoy looking at and visiting the boats. Miss French Guiana is Rose Nicole Lani, and Carol Bonke is Miss Chile. A lucky boat to have a lovely crew like Miss Iceland, Berglund Johansson, Miss Sri Lanka, Nyomini Ilomagoda, and Miss Yugoslavia, Ksenia Borojavic. Boat watching appeals to the threesome of Miss Canada, Cynthia Curluck, Miss Peru, Fioreya Ferrari Iglesias, and Mae Shanley, Miss USA. From down under and Eastern Europe come this combination of Donna Rudrum, Miss Australia, and Miss Poland, Joanna Karska. Their patterns are dots and stripes. Their names are Juhi Chawla, Miss India, and Mary Lee Shiga, Miss Reunion. Next, we move from the ocean, past the palm trees, across the putting greens, to the pool of the Key Biscayne Hotel and Villas, where we meet 10 lovely ladies. All in a row, and like them, we sit up and take notice as we meet each member of the group, starting with Miss Tyler, Sabani Kagarana. Now it's sunglasses off and a smile on for Miss Ireland, Trish Nolan. Next, two South Americans, Miss Bolivia, Lourdes Elizabeth Aponte, and Miss Ecuador, Lenor Patrice Gonzenbach. Donna Fratt is Miss British Virgin Islands. White diamonds on a black swimsuit worn by Miss Japan, Megumi Nia. Next, we meet Lorena Slay, Miss Western Samoa. On the other side of the Atlantic Ocean is Mae Monaghan, Miss Scotland. This is Suzanne Maria Verbrugge, who is Miss Curaçao. And one more pair of sunglasses come off, those of Ellie Benavente Umagin, Miss Guam. One of Miami's most popular sightseeing attractions is the famous Vizcaya, a magnificent Italian Renaissance-style palace with beautiful formal gardens and guests to match, like Miss England, Louise Gray, Chaniel Clary, Miss Martinique, and Violet Huiman Lee, Miss Singapore. We move across the gardens to one of the unusual attractions at Vizcaya, the stone boat. On this day, there are some other special attractions. A lovely trio of Thora Creighton, Miss Cayman Islands, Miss Uruguay, Gisa Pronzati, and Miss Aruba, Jacqueline Van Putten. We see stripes of different types on the swimsuits of Miss Guadalupe, Martine Serema, and Jane Riley, who is Miss Wales. A magnificent stone boat serves as a breakwater and also as a meeting place for two lovely ladies from opposite sides of the world. Latifa Hamid, who is Miss Malaysia. And Miss Guatemala, Julieta Uritia. Classic stone columns tower above the beautiful blue water, which has captured the attention of Rocky and his two lovely Latin friends. On his right, Elena Ortiz, Miss Paraguay, and on his left, Miss El Salvador, Ana Lorena Samajoa. On the beach at Key Biscayne stands a lighthouse, and it's in the shadow of that lighthouse, wearing a suede and bead-fringed suit, that we greet Lukanji Luwale, Miss Zaire. From Europe and Latin America, we welcome Miss Belgium, Brigitte Monchon, and Miss Costa Rica, Silvia Portilla Pasta. A common language unites Miss Portugal, Fatima Jordi, Miss Brazil, Ana Elisa Flores. A picnic bench in the shade is relaxed for Miss Gambia, Mirabel Carriel, and Miss Finland, Ana Lisa Tielitz. Two young ladies from Europe quench their thirst at the same table. Miss Sweden, Yvonne Reading, and Martine Robin, Miss France. Let a smile be your umbrella, or better yet, have both, like Mertice Hyde, Miss Honduras. At Port Miami, the Funship Festival plays host to some lovely international passengers. You can slide into the pool past such pretty sights as Miss Denmark, Katrina Clausen, Gina Maria Tardier, Miss Trinidad Tobago, and Garbina Abosolo Garcia, Miss Spain. Solids and color blocks are the choices of Miss Colombia, Susanna Caldas Lemaitre, and Ingrid Martins, Miss Norway. At the bottom of the ship's huge mast, we find a black tank suit with gold flecks worn by Miss Cyprus, Jaja Melodius. Keeping an eye on the compass is Rhonda Wilkinson, Miss Bermuda. Viewing the skyline are Miss Mexico, Elizabeth Broden, and Margaret Brown, who is Miss Cook Islands. Our final twosome selects what looks like everyone's favorite pastime, lying in the sun. Miss Venezuela is Carmen Maria Montiel, and Patricia Maria Graham, Miss U.S. Virgin Islands. And now, from aboard their cruise liner, our young ladies get together to send some greetings, not only to our host city in the background, but to people all over the world, from the contestants in the 1984 Miss Universe pageant. Time now to learn the names of our 10 semifinalists. Our beautiful contestants are here on stage with us in their lovely dresses by Catalina. As Joan mentioned, our panel has spent the past week judging our contestants in three areas of competition: evening gowns, swimsuits, and personal interviews. The result of that judging is ready, and I'm going to pick up the computer printout of the judge's decision right now. Now, have that, please. The names of our 10 semifinalists, one of whom will become Miss Universe. Now, the names I am about to read will be at random, not reflecting scoring, alphabetical order, or any other design. The scores shown to our audience at home will be the composite average score which each semifinalist received from the three preliminary competitions. Here we go. Good luck to all of you. The first name is Miss Germany. And now, come on down, Miss USA. We want Miss Thailand. And how do you folks here in Miami feel about Miss Sweden? Just bet you're going to like Miss Holland. Number six on the list is Miss Guatemala. Another contestant who has a chance to be Miss Universe is Miss Philippines. To number eight, and number eight is Miss South Africa. And here comes Miss Venezuela. We have one more name, one more beauty delegate who has a chance to be Miss Universe. She is Miss Colombia. Congratulations to our 10 semifinalists. Before this night is over, one of them will be the new Miss Universe.
Well, the preliminary judging by our panel has resulted in the selection of our 10 semifinalists. And the top scorers were Miss Sweden first, second place went to Miss Philippines, and third place was Miss Venezuela. Now, the preliminary scores are tossed out completely, and the 10 semifinalists begin all even. And you at home, you're now all even with our judges here. Because from this point on, their decision on who will be our five finalists will be based on what both you and they see and hear. As a matter of fact, you'll have a slight advantage because you'll get to see the average scores which aren't available to them. And that might be a good reason to have a pencil and paper handy. Coming up, the first of our semifinalist competitions, personal interviews, and that happens right after this word from Lemon-Scented Cascade.
We have met our 10 semifinalists, and now we are going to get to know them as we start the interview competition. Now, this is truly live television. The young ladies don't know what I'll ask them, and I don't know what they'll say. Whatever happens, we'll find out together, and that includes the judges here. The judges will give each contestant an average score in this competition, and that will appear on your screens at home. Each young woman has been advised that if she desires, an interpreter is available for her. Now, our first contestant in the Miss Universe interview competition is you, Miss Germany. Would you step right out here to me, please? Miss Germany is Brigitte Barrett. She's 22, and she manages a ladies' boutique, and I believe you would like to have a translator.
Yes, hello.
Would you help us, please? She manages a ladies' boutique. Ask her to tell us about her job, please.
Sag uns ein bisschen über deine Arbeit. Also erstmal kaufe ich ein für eine Boutique. Ich sorge dafür, dass das Personal immer rechtzeitig da ist. I buy for a boutique and I always make sure that all the personnel is there on time.
She's a buyer?
Yeah.
Does she travel about Europe buying or where does she buy?
Reist du durch Europa, um zu kaufen? Nein, ich gehe auf Messen, zum Beispiel die Egedo in Düsseldorf. Und da order ich die Ware vor, viel aus Italien. Das ist ziemlich modern. I go to different fairs and I order the merchandise from different cities and import them into Düsseldorf.
Like most women, does she buy a lot of clothes for herself?
Kaufst du auch viel Kleider für dich selbst ein? Ja, ab und zu auch mal. Now and again, yes.
As a buyer, does she have to pay the full price?
Musst du den vollen Preis bezahlen als Käuferin? Nein, ich bekomme den Einkaufspreis. No, I get the wholesale price.
For Miss Germany, the price is right. Thank you, Miss Germany. Thank you. You'll see the score at home, and we'll talk with Miss USA. She is Mae Shanley, 21, from Alamogordo, New Mexico. She's studying education at New Mexico State University, and you were crowned Miss USA on the 17th of May up here in Lakeland, Florida. And what's happened to you since?
Well, since I've been crowned Miss USA for the last month and a half, I've been in a whirlwind of activities. I've been in 15 cities, east and west in the United States, north and south. And most important, I've had the opportunity to come here to the Universe Pageant to meet 82 wonderful contestants. And this is a place where we've been able to emphasize mutual understanding and get to know each other. And I've also had the opportunity to meet our president, President Reagan of the United States of America.
Wow, wonderful. All of us see President Reagan on television all the time. What's he like in person?
President Reagan is a very gentle person, and I had the opportunity to present him with a signed program book. I was like a spokesperson for the 82 contestants, and he was very nice, and he was very honored. He kept it in the Oval Office, and as a matter of fact, he said he wished all the girls the best of luck in the 1984 Miss Universe pageant.
Did you invite him to watch the telecast?
I sure did.
In the event that he is, Mr. President, I would like to talk about the personal income tax. No, this is a fun show. Thank you, Miss USA.
Thank you.
Miss Thailand, would you join me right out here? She's Savinay Parganong, and she's 19. She lives in Bangkok. And tell us about the fun you've been having in Miami, will you please?
I've been having lots of fun here with all the girls. We've been to the beach and to the many sites that are here in Miami. Met a lot of people and had a lot of fun.
You speak perfect English. Where did you learn to speak English so well?
In Los Angeles.
Were you an exchange student?
No, I lived in Los Angeles for many years.
Oh, you did? Where'd you go to high school?
Temple City High School.
Here she is from one of the most exotic countries in the world, a graduate of Temple City High School in Los Angeles. What are your plans for the future, Ms. Thailand?
I plan to go back to school.
Where, in Los Angeles?
Yes,
of course.
UCLA.
And then what?
And then plan to open a business of my own around the fields of fashion or health spa.
Back in Thailand?
Yes.
No, we must convince them that you do speak Thai. I know what they'd like to hear. You tell this audience that the Miami University football team will win it all again in 1984 in Thai. Now wait, she's going to tell you in Thai.
Team football ของ Miami จะชนะค่ะปีนี
้ Is that all there is to it?
Yes.
All right, thank you, Miss Thailand. The Hurricanes hope it'll be that easy. Your score at home, but we do not see that in the theater, nor do the judges see it. I'm going to talk with you next, Miss Sweden. She's Yvonne Reading. She's 21. She's a licensed practical nurse. How long have you been a nurse?
3.5 years.
And your chaperone told me that you have gone to a Miami hospital with a sore throat.
Yes, I am.
As a nurse, do you think they took good care of you there at the Miami hospital?
Yes, they took a very good care of me, yes.
That should be reassuring to you folks who are planning to get sick here in Miami. Now, you are a practical nurse.
Yes.
And you are here in Miami. Have you been to the United States before?
Yes, I have. This is the third time in the United States.
Where have you visited?
I have been, for 6 years ago, I was in New Jersey and played soccer.
Where else?
And I've been in Seattle, Washington State.
In Washington?
Yes.
Did you visit Darrington, Washington?
No.
Did the state officials tell you anything about the historical significance of Darrington, Washington? You mean no one told you that Bob Barker was born in Darrington, Washington?
No.
There was no monument on the highway? Not even a refrigerator?
I'm sorry.
You're forgiven. Thank you, Ms. Sweden.
Thank you.
Miss Holland, who is Nancy Nada, 20, from Amsterdam, a model. And Miss Holland, is this your first trip to the United States?
Yeah, it's my first trip, and I love it.
Good. What are you going to tell your friends back in Holland about our country?
It's big, beautiful beach, and I try to work here.
You'd like to work here?
Yes, model, yeah.
Speaking of working, I read in your bio that your father is a master of ceremony.
Yeah, he is. He's terrific. He's sitting over there with a white suit.
He's here. He's here. And he's here, and he's handsome, and he's an MC, and I hope he goes home tomorrow. Thank you, Miss Holland.
Thank you.
You see her score. And you have met half of our semifinalists. How about it, you armchair judges? Is one of them going to be the new Miss Universe?
Picked out a possible winner from the five who were just interviewed? We better hold off until you hear from the other five, and that will happen when Bob returns for more of the interview competition after this word from Pringles.
We've had a chance to meet five of our semifinalists, and now it's time to talk with the other five, and Miss Guatemala is first. Right down here, please. Julieta Yuritia, 21, from Guatemala City. She's studying law, and you would like to have an interpreter.
Yes.
Will you join us, please? Now, she's studying law. Ask her how much longer it will be before she becomes a lawyer. How many more years of study
does she have? ¿Quieres saber cuánto tiempo te falta estudiar para graduarte de abogado?
2 años y medio.
2.5 years.
And what type of law does she want to specialize in?
¿Qué tipo de leyes te vas a especializar?
Me gustaría mucho derecho penal.
Penal code.
Penal code?
Yes.
And what does that mean she will do?
In a Roman law system, that means criminal law.
She's going to be a criminal lawyer. Ask her why she chose criminal law.
¿Por qué has escogido este tipo de leyes?
Porque es muy humano y me gusta mucho tratar con las personas de cerca, defender a la persona en sí.
Because it is very humane. And I like to defend people and good causes.
Well, that's very good. Now, let me try. I'm going to see if she's learned any English here. ¿Qué puede decir in inglés?
Hi.
Hi. Now, wait. You laughed and you missed something very important here. What did you say? ¿Qué dice?
Hi. I love you. Hi.
She's moved along very rapidly since she came to Miami. Anything else? Hungry?
Algo más.
Algo más?
Oh, no.
Hungry?
¿Tienes hambre?
Tired?
No.
No, I don't mean now. I know you're not. But during the rehearsals, I thought maybe you'd become tired. Thank you, Miss Guatemala. Thank you. You see her score at home, and we talk next with Miss Philippines, who is Desiree Verdadera, 21, Manila. She is a model, and how long have you been a model?
2 years.
What type of modeling do you do?
I'm a romp and commercial model.
Now, you know there are literally thousands of girls watching us right now on CBS who would like to be models. What would you like to tell them about the job?
Well, modeling is not an easy job. And it's also not a stable job.
You have to be unstable to be a model, isn't it? It is. Sometimes you have a lot of work, and sometimes there are times when you have no work.
Yes.
Do you have an agent who represents you?
No, I'm a freelancer model.
And you make your own?
I have lots of friends who are designers, so when they want to get me, they will get me.
And do they get you often?
Oh, yes.
Then you don't need an agent.
No.
All right. Thank you, Miss Philippines. Miss South Africa, will you come over here to me, please? She's Letitia Snayman, age 20, from Durban. At the moment, being Miss South Africa is a full-time job, but what are your career plans?
I plan to, hopefully next year, also go into professional modeling. There's just so many people that I meet, so many things that I do, that my ideals are changing all the time. And I think by the end of my reign as Miss South Africa, I'll have something totally new to do.
Being Miss South Africa has opened many doors for
you. Yes, it
has. That's very good. That's good. Now, I read in your bio that you're an animal lover and that you're active in the animal rights movement. Would you like to tell us about that?
Yes, I've always been very, very fond of animals, always loved them dearly. And when I won, I decided that I could use my title in a very good way and help animals with it as such. And the beauty without cruelty, things like that, I decided I could really do a lot for them. And young girls have taken to me. They can learn a lot from me. And it's really good to do something for something that's meant so much to me my whole life.
I commend you for it. There's a fellow on television here in the United States. I forget his name for the moment, but he's always saying, help control the pet population. Have your pets spayed or neutered. That's important, isn't it?
Yes, it is important.
Thank you very much.
Thank you, Bob.
Bye. And Miss Venezuela. Carmen Maria Montiel, 19, she lives in Maracaibo, and she's studying art at the Central University of Venezuela, and she would like to have one of you help her. Will you do that, please? Now, I have been told about a foundation that she has in Venezuela, a trust into which she's putting money that she wins in pageants. Would you ask her to tell us about that?
Nos han dicho que usted tiene una fundación en Venezuela en la que ha puesto dinero. ¿Nos puede hablar, por favor, sobre eso?
Sí, por supuesto. Al ganar Miss Venezuela, lo que más yo quería era no tener una corona por satisfacer mi ego, sino poner una corona a trabajar para las obras benéficas, la gente que nos necesita. Como reina de Venezuela, la gente siempre me escucha y muchas personas sienten la necesidad de ir a alguien que los va a oír. Yo puedo pedir ayudas económicas, también puedo pedir para que nos ayuden en algunos remedios.
I couldn't have said it better myself. What did she say?
When I won Miss Venezuela, I didn't want to just have a crown for myself. I wanted to help other people and use that crown to give money and to help the poor, the people that need me. And people listen to people that are important places, so I would like to use my position to help.
I think that's wonderful. Now, I have been told that... Maracaibo is much like Texas, that there's a lot of money, a lot of oil wells. Ask her if she has ever seen Dallas on television.
Dicen que Maracaibo se parece mucho a Texas. Y si ha visto alguna vez el programa Dallas en la televisión.
Por supuesto, es uno de los programas con más sintonía en Venezuela. Yo suelo verlo a veces.
It is one of the most popular programs in Venezuela. I watch it quite often.
Does she like Senor Ewing?
¿Le gusta el señor Ewing?
Bueno, creo que es un hombre algo justo.
I think he is somewhat just.
All right. Thank you very much, Ms. Denzel. Thank you. You see her score, and we continue with Miss Colombia, who is Susana Caldas La Maitre. She is 20. She lives in Cartagena. She is a recent high school graduate, and she would like to have a translator standing by, but I think she's going to try English. You come out here and help us if she needs you. What are your plans for the future? What are you going to do now?
I want to study architecture, and I will begin to study in
August?
January.
January.
January of 19.
Well, I had chances were 12-1 against me now. I beg your pardon?
January 1985.
Architecture.
Yes.
What do you think of the architecture here in Miami, the buildings, the skyline?
Well, it's so modern, and I liked... Can I say it in Spanish?
Certainly.
Es muy moderna, me parece una arquitectura que... todos admiramos porque va continua con la modernización, va avanzando y cada día se hacen estructuras muy diferentes.
It is very modern and we admire it very much because it is progressing and it is progressing and modernizing with every day something new coming up.
Yes, it is. Now, What are you going to do? I know you've had a wonderful time. I know you've had a wonderful time here in Miami. What are you going to do first when you get home?
Well, I think I drink a very big cup of coffee. Colombian coffee.
Thank you, Miss Colombia. Thank you. The interviews have been completed and the scores entered into our computer. I hope that you at home have made your choices too. And remember, there is more competition ahead.
Collected those young women were thousands of miles from home, language barriers aside, and Bob, of course, helped make it all look so easy. Well, congratulations, ladies, and congratulations, Bob. Now, in the personal interview competition, first place went to Miss Colombia, second place was Miss Venezuela, and third place was Miss South Africa. Okay, just as there is a famous moon over Miami, tonight there is also a famous star in Miami. Actually, superstar would be more accurate. His name is Tom Jones, and he's going to be with us right after this word from Safeguard.
The international flavor of our pageant is enhanced by the appearance of our special guest. His soon-to-be-released single is called All the Love is on the Radio. Fortunately for us, tonight his talent is on television. The Miss Universe pageant is pleased to welcome the most exciting singer in the world, Tom Jones.
All the love is on the radio. Hear songs about you everywhere I go. Are you lonesome tonight? Your life could make it feel right. Sorry for the things I said that day. Do you miss me since you went away? Tell me, darling, do you want to go? I sleep in my arms again. Places where there is no end to paradise. Girl, I could make you feel nice. All the love is on the
Right now, there are 10 lovely young women in full pursuit of a dream, the answer to which one of them will be the new Miss Universe must come from our distinguished panel of celebrity judges. And now I'd like you to meet them. This award-winning actress created her first TV series role as Clarissa McCandless on the CBS daytime drama Capital. Her real-life role is that of the wife of the U.S. Ambassador to Mexico, John Gavin. Please welcome Constance Towers. He is soon to be seen in the sequel to his very successful film, They Call Me Bruce. This one is called Inspector Bruce. He is Johnny Yoon. This Venezuelan-born designer is known worldwide for her sophisticated and elegant Coacher collections and for her frequent appearance on the lists of the world's best-dressed women. Here is Carolina Herrera. He is a founding partner of Creative Artists Agency and has been described by the Wall Street Journal as the most important agent in the television industry, William Haber. While she has co-designed a line of evening wear for Canadian distribution, she is also an actress and a model and is currently writing a book. She is best known, especially to tonight's audience around the world, as Miss Universe 1982. Here is Karen Baldwin. A highly respected and busy dramatic actor, he has recently completed a starring role in the Paramount Television miniseries, The Jesse Owens Story, and is currently working with Eddie Murphy on a new film from Paramount called Beverly Hills Cop. Please welcome Ronnie Cox. The star of major motion pictures, dramatic television, and her own television variety series, she is described as one of Latin America's most famous international actresses and singers. Soon to star in a new TV series, she is Lucia Mendez. All-American running back at USC, Heisman Trophy winner and most valuable player in the 1984 Super Bowl. Credentials like that can only mean the Los Angeles Raiders superstar Marcus Allen. Her talent as a painter has resulted in several exhibitions, and her beauty has inspired world-famous artists and sculptors. An actress who made films in 5 different languages and whose 2 daughters by husband Tyrone Power are also actresses. She is Linda Christian. Truly a master of his craft, he has starred in comedies, dramas, and musicals on television, movies, and the Broadway stage, where he has co-starred in the highly acclaimed musical Woman of the Year. Please welcome Harry Gordino. Born in Fairfax, Oklahoma, she went on to be universally recognized as America's first great prima ballerina. After being a soloist with the Ballet Russe de Monte Carlo, she became prima ballerina for the New York City Ballet. Now the artistic director of the Chicago City Ballet, she is Maria Tallchief. An Emmy Award-winning writer, a composer, a producer of both television series and specials, he has now become a favorite with television audiences as the host of his own late-night talk show. Here is Alan Thicke. Our distinguished celebrity panel of judges.
Nothing illustrates the international excitement created by the Miss Universe pageant more than this scene. This telecast, seen by more than 700 million people on 6 continents, calls for running commentaries in many languages, as you can hear right here. This gentleman, for example, Pepe Ludmere, is doing a commentary for Spanish-speaking nations. He's a fixture at our pageants. In fact, this is his 33rd. Pepe, what were you just saying?
¿Qué es lo que decía? I was saying that you're a beautiful woman. Decía que eres una mujer linda.
Oh, muchas gracias, Pepe. Pepe, how many countries will hear this pageant in Spanish?
¿Cuántos países siguen la ceremonia? 17, including my own, Peru, 17. I'm doing it for Panamericana in Lima. Here in the back, Mexico is doing it live. And the front, Colombia, is doing it live.
How about the other languages, the other countries?
Probably another 20. By far, this is the most widely seen television show in the world.
700 million people, in fact. Thank you, Pepe. You can see that our winner truly deserves the title of Miss Universe, and we'll move one step closer to finding out her name when our last semifinalist area of judging, the swimsuit competition, takes place right after this word from Head and Shoulders.
With its weather and Atlantic coast beaches, Miami seems the perfect place for our second judging category, the swimsuit competition. Each judge will enter a score for each contestant into our computer, and you at home will see the contestant's average score on your television screens. The setting represents Vizcaya, a beautiful Italian villa whose gardens and mansion and magnificent vistas combine for a highlight of any Miami sightseeing trip. Here in their swimwear by Catalina are the 10 semifinalists in the Miss Universe swimsuit competition. Miss Germany.
Brigitta is 5'7" tall and weighs 121 pounds. She's 22 years old and she's a blue-eyed blonde.
USA.
Twenty-one-year-old May is 5'7" tall and weighs 117 pounds. She has hazel eyes and black hair.
Miss Thailand.
Stephanie has dark brown eyes and black hair. She's 19 years old, 5'6" tall, and she weighs 115 pounds.
Miss Sweden.
Yvonne is a blue-eyed blonde. She's 5'7" tall and weighs 114 pounds. Yvonne is 21 years old.
Miss Holland.
Nancy has dark brown hair and eyes, weighs 132 pounds, and stands 5'10" tall. Nancy is 20 years old.
Miss Guatemala.
Julieta has dark brown eyes and black hair. She's 21 years old, 5'8" tall, and weighs 118 pounds.
Miss Philippines.
Desiree is 5'6½" tall and weighs 112 pounds. She's 21 years old with black hair and dark brown eyes.
Miss South Africa.
20-year-old Letitia weighs 127 pounds and is 5'8" tall. Her hair is blonde and her eyes are green.
Miss Venezuela.
19-year-old Carmen has blue eyes and dark brown hair. She's 5'9" tall, and she weighs 114 pounds.
Miss Colombia.
Susanna has light brown hair and green eyes. She's 20 years old, 5'8" tall, and she weighs 119 pounds.
Semi-finalists in tonight's Miss Universe swimsuit competition.
Well, two-thirds of our semi-finalist competition is over. We have just seen our 10 young ladies in their swimwear, and so have our judges, who gave the highest point total to Miss Sweden, second place, Miss Venezuela, and third place was a tie. I don't believe it's the first time for me to see this, Germany and Miss Philippines tie. Okay, Miami is the center of competition tonight, but it is also regarded as a place to live, work, and visit. Miami may not be considered the South to a lady from New Zealand, but to one of them, Miss Universe 1983 Lorraine Downs, it is at least considered fascinating.
No surprise that in Miami, relaxation is where you find it. What can be a surprise are some of the places that you find it. Open air, hot tubs aren't always constructed at ground level, nor on the roof. In this case, right in the middle of this distinctive building located along Miami's fashionable Brickell Avenue. Whether it's colorful architecture or an exterior that covers the spectrum, high-rise living in the Miami area certainly deserves the word unique. For those who prefer Biscayne Bay or the Atlantic Ocean to a hot tub, there are some lifestyles that don't depend on the elevator working, maybe just the sun shining. Speaking of working, recently Miami has been working on a railroad, and now that their brand new Metrorail has been opened, it's a fast and convenient way for thousands of Miamians to get to work. Next stop, Overtown. In the growing Miami economy, not all the people in high places are executives. At whatever level, they make this an important city in banking, insurance, finance, conventioneering, import-export, and high-tech occupations. But along with the modern, you'll find the traditional, like the fine art of cigar rolling, which some Miamians brought with them from another land. While a good cigar is supposed to go up in smoke, memories are forever, especially if there are colorful cruises that began for them in Miami, the world's busiest cruise port. Moving from ports to sports is easy in Miami, whether your interest is the skill and acrobatics of high life, the sound and speed of Miami's famous Grand Prix races, or the sport of teams, featuring the best in the way of thoroughbreds. Not to mention jockeys, both male and female. I'm not really a race rider, but I love the outfit. Once Miami Beach was only a playland, but today it is truly a place to live, work, and visit. One thing that has always meant Miami Beach to the rest of the world is the site of the famous resort hotels along Collins Avenue. This beautiful beach, reclaimed and restored by Miami Beach, proves again that this area provides no shortage of memories for the album of any visitor. Including me, and it's going to provide one young woman with a breathtaking memory when she is crowned Miss Universe. So let's go back to the convention center where that's going to happen.
Thank you, Lorraine. With her help, we've all seen some of the sights of Miami, and ahead, thanks to our contestants, we have an exciting musical treat featuring the sounds of Miami. And that happens right after this word from Duncan Hines Cake Mix.
Sister pageants in the Miss Universe family, Miss Teen USA is the newest, and there is, of course, the Miss USA pageant, which will be held in Lakeland, Florida, and we're pleased to welcome that city's mayor, the Honorable Peggy Brown. We would also like to acknowledge three people who have been such important factors in our visit to Miami tonight. Maurice Ferrer, Mayor of Miami, Malcolm H. Fromberg, Mayor of Miami Beach, and Commissioner Joe Carollo, Chairman of the Greater Miami Host Commission. Gentlemen, thank you. Now with the fabulous Miami Sound Machine, our young ladies pay a musical tribute to the scenery and cultures of Miami, along with its sounds, sounds that can be as different as day and night.
One, two, one, two, three.
Young women had never seen each other. Whoa! Many had to be spoken to through interpreters. And yet tonight, look, they've all pulled together into the wonderful group we just saw. Good girl. Of course, this meant a lot of rehearsals, but for our young women, it wasn't all work. There was also time for fun. So let's take a look.
From all over Latin America, our contestants headed for Miami and the pageant on Eastern Airlines. Their first glimpse of their destination was the Miami Beach coastline, and they wondered, is that where my dream will come true? Meanwhile, from London aboard Air Florida came another group of candidates and another group of dreams. One young lady brought a tiny stuffed koala, while another brought her great big teddy. But for some who wanted to rest, it was all more than they could bear. A visit to the Miami Zoo brought our lady some new friends, including a crossword puzzle favorite, the tapir, a very elusive python that did not answer to the name Monty, and some elephants who liked not only peanuts but candies. Candy shoes, that is, worn by the lovely elephant riders, you Tarzan, me contestants. At sea or on land, music means dancing, and that meant the limbo, where the audience included some future Miss Universe contestants, and our young ladies bent over backwards to have a good time aboard the fun ship Carnival. A different kind of space launch at the Miami Seaquarium, where the ladies met a new friend, a whale who made a big splash of approval over their Catalina sportswear outfits, all over them, in fact. Later, he took one of them for a whaleback ride, and he couldn't help saying, if the gang at my old school could see me now. Windsurfing, and Miss Norway was good at it. Some had problems, but not Miss Norway. Even the boats had problems, but not Miss Norway. She lost to the law of gravity, and Miss Norway finally lost to the law of averages. Hardly what might be described as the agony of defeat. Coast of Key Largo near Pennycamp State Park, our ladies went scuba diving in search of treasure. What would Miss Universe contestants want to find? Not gold doubloons, not precious jewels. There it is, a Miss Universe crown. Well, if the crown fits, wear it. One of the most popular people at every pageant is Stan Place, who advises our young ladies on one of their favorite subjects. We're at the Pavillon Hotel, which played host to our contestants and also to the makeup clinic held by Maybelline, official cosmetics for the 1984 Miss Universe pageant. For a group of international ladies, it seemed only right for them to gather at an international nightclub. And this time it was Regine's. The music, the atmosphere, and the fashions were as modern as the ladies themselves. But their feelings reflected a song of another time and tempo. I could have danced all night. Oh, yeah.
Ladies, hey, I've got somebody here who's had your dream come true. Do you happen to know her name?
Sylvia!
Oh, not only bright, but beautiful, too. That's right, this is Sylvia Hitchcock Carson, and though I know you ladies won't believe me, she was crowned Miss Universe in Miami Beach in 1967, right?
Would you believe I was six at the time?
I absolutely could believe it, looking at you. Do you have any advice for these gorgeous ladies getting ready?
Well, I tell you, I think they're so excited right now that they could hardly be able to listen to me, but what I really hope is that they have benefited like I have from the growth and prestige of the pageant.
Well, I happen to know that you've contributed to the growth and prestige by all your community and charity works here in your home state of Florida.
Thank you, Joan.
Listen, did anything kind of unusual or interesting happen to you when you got dressed ready for the evening gown competition?
Oh, I would say so.
What was that?
When I won, the bouffant styles were in, and all I could think about all evening was, oh, they're going to collapse.
Oh, but obviously it didn't collapse, and neither did you. Good luck, Sylvia, and good luck to all you ladies as you get ready for the evening gown competition, which comes up right after this word from Scope.
For the third and last category of semi-finalist competition, evening gowns, each of our young ladies will wear a gown of her own choice. Our audience at home will again see each contestant's average score. We will see a beautiful blending of yesterday and tomorrow as the young ladies appear in an Art Deco setting so popular in the Florida of a half century ago. Every contestant in the pageant has enjoyed the company of a little sister, a Miami youngster, and each semifinalist is now accompanied by her little sister, perhaps in Miss Universe of tomorrow, in the 1984 Miss Universe Evening Gown Competition. Miss Germany.
Oh,
Philippines. South Africa. Venezuela. Colombia.
Semi-final competitions, and the top spot in the evening gown competition went to Miss Sweden, second place went to Miss Venezuela, and third place was Miss Philippines. Now you can compare your judgment with our panels when we announce our five finalists right after this word from CAMA.
There were thousands of young women all over the world who dreamed of being Miss Universe. Then there were 81, then there were 10. In just a moment, the 10 will become 5. The computer has taken all the votes of our panel and come up with the names of our five finalists, and I am going to pick up the names of those five finalists right now. May I have them, please? One of these contestants will be the new Miss Universe. Now, the composite score each young woman received in tonight's competition will appear on your television screens as she is introduced. Again, those introductions will be in no particular order, and again, good luck to all 10 of you. Here we go with the names of the five finalists. Number one is Miss Philippines. Miss Sweden. Next is Miss South Africa. Now, Miss Venezuela. There's only one to go. Who will it be? It will be Miss Colombia. From these five lovely young women, our judges will pick the new Miss Universe. For the new Miss Universe, the rewards are both tangible and intangible. The intangibles include prestige, glamour, and international recognition. The tangibles are a prize package which includes $102,500 in cash. In cash and merchandise, the Miss Universe prizes will total over $175,000, including a $25,000 personal appearance contract and a $15,000 first prize award, plus each of the sensational prizes Joan is going to tell us about.
The 1984 Miss Universe will fly first class to any eastern destination of her choice, whether it's to the beautiful beaches of Florida, an enchanting Caribbean island, or the splendor of South America. She'll fly with Eastern, the new leader in service to all the Americas. Along with a $10,000 fashion wardrobe by Fernando Pena, modeled in part here at Henry Moore's sculpture Spindle, the new Miss Universe will also receive a $5,000 cash award, all from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the Miss Universe pageant. Tonight's winner, as befits a Miss Universe, like our model Rain Downs, will be able to arrive anywhere in style, wearing this beautiful natural shadow mink coat. It's from the internationally famous Flemington Fur Company. Before, during, and after a day of sightseeing at some place like Miami's beautiful Vizcaya, our winner can enjoy a year's supply of the unique scent, Daydreams, who will also present to her a $7,500 cash award. Miss Universe will receive the sporty Wellcraft 180 Elite Bow Rider from the Wellcraft Marine Corporation. She will also receive a 115 horsepower outboard motor from Evinrude and a trailer from Shoreline Products. When Miss Universe is relaxing, she loves to slip into something tan with Coppertone, who will present her with a $5,000 cash prize and a 5-year supply of Coppertone tanning products. Coppertone for the tan, for the protection, for the moisturizers. So she'll look her best on occasions like this sail aboard the Tyche, our new Miss Universe will receive a $10,000 cash award plus a 5-year supply of cosmetics from Maybelline, the official cosmetics for the 1984 Miss Universe pageant. Always on the lookout for the latest in fashion, the new Miss Universe can use her versatile sportswear for cruising or personal appearances. She will receive a $10,000 cash award and an all-season wardrobe from Catalina. To this year's winner goes a $5,000 cash award, a beautiful collection of jewelry, and her symbol of elegance, her crown, all from Aubrey Creations. You're welcome. Along with a $5,000 cash award, Miss Universe will receive a high-performance X700 program camera and accessories, plus this advanced portable autofocus video system, only from the mind of Minolta. A complete Candy's wardrobe that captures fashion's latest trend. Candy's keeping up with a young, dynamic image of life in the fast lane that sets the pace for all Candy's fashion. Miss Universe will receive a handcrafted 18-karat gold full-cut 70-diamond bracelet watch. It's guaranteed Swiss quartz accuracy to within 60 seconds a year by Tourneau to keep her on time wherever she may travel. Every step of the way, Miss Universe is a no-nonsense woman. She'll stay on the go with $10,000 in cash, plus a 5-year supply of the pantyhose that fits her right. No-nonsense pantyhose, beautiful. Pan Am, America's airline to the world, will fly Miss Universe and a companion of her choice, first class, to anywhere around the world they fly. Pan Am, you can't beat the experience. Wherever she decides to go, the new Miss Universe will be a real hit when she arrives in one of America's most popular sports cars, the fully equipped 1984 Mazda RX-7 GS. All these wonderful prizes and gifts are waiting for the new Miss Universe.
Now that we've seen what Miss Universe will win, let's just see who some of our audience right here in Miami thinks might win it. Let me ask you, who do you think is going to be Miss Universe tonight?
I think it will be Miss Venezuela.
Yes, and why?
Why? Because she's gorgeous.
She's gorgeous?
A lot of class.
A lot of class, that sounds good enough to me. Maybe Miss Venezuela. How about, I'd like a gentleman's opinion here. Who do you think the judges will pick tonight for Miss Universe?
Well, I think there's no doubt they'll pick Miss Colombia.
Right here. official judges at home have heard from some unofficial judges right here in the theater, and before long, we're all going to know the answer. So if you'd like just one more close-up look before making your final choice, well, you're going to get that chance when we come back after this word from Secret, the official antiperspirant of the 1984 Miss Universe pageant.
About to ask each of our five finalists the same question. Now, as I speak with one of the young ladies, the other four will be in our completely soundproof booth so they cannot hear what she has said. And we're happy to have, over at the door of the booth to help us, Charisse Haugen, Miss Teen USA 1984, and Sylvia Hitchcock Carson, Miss USA and Miss Universe 1967. Now, Miss Philippines, will you step over to me, and you four, please step into the booth. Of course, our judges will continue their evaluation as you answer spontaneously and, of course, unrehearsed. Into the booth and close the door, please. Now, Miss Philippines, the question is, should you be the new Miss Universe, you will become a symbol to young women and girls all over the world. What would you like to tell them?
Well, all I want to tell them is being Miss Universe is a pride, and I'd like to spread peace and goodwill to all nations. That's all.
Thank you, Miss Philippines. Now, Miss Venezuela. Miss Venezuela, right out here to me. She wants an interpreter. Will you step over to me, please? And would you read this question to her?
Si usted fuera la nueva Miss Universo, sería un símbolo para todas las mujeres jóvenes y chicas de todas partes del mundo. ¿Qué les gustaría decirle?
Bueno, yo quisiera darle mi mensaje como mujer que emprende una nueva labor, que se preparen, que trabajen, porque en nuestras manos hoy en día está el futuro. Nosotras.
I would like to tell all young women of this world to prepare themselves and to work because in our hands lies the future.
Thank you very much. Now, may I have Miss Sweden? Miss Sweden, right out here to me. And Miss Sweden, the question is, should you be the new Miss Universe, you will become a symbol to young women and girls all over the world. What would you like to tell them?
Yes, I think I wanted to tell them that have their own personality to always try to stand with the both feet on the floor and try to, well, I think that is most important, to always standing with both feet on the floor and try to do other people happy and help.
And help others.
Yes.
Thank you, Miss Sweden. Now, Miss Columbia. Miss Columbia, will you help us, please? Miss Columbia would like to have you read her the question.
Si usted fuera la nueva Miss Universo, sería un símbolo para todas las mujeres y chicas de todo el mundo. ¿Qué les gustaría decirle?
Bueno, yo creo que el trabajo de toda mujer en su hogar, en su familia, es dar un poquito de paz. Tal vez llevaría un símbolo de paz para todo el mundo y trataría de que todo el mundo llevara consigo un poquito de paz para poder irradiar paz.
I think it is the job of a woman in her family and in her life to radiate peace, and I think I would like to give a symbol of peace to the entire world.
Thank you, Miss Columbia. Miss South Africa. Miss South Africa, should you be the new Miss Universe, you will become a symbol to young women and girls all over the world. What would you like to tell them?
I would like to tell them that beauty is not a physical thing. It's something that's inside you, and only you can bring that out, and only you can show that to the world. It's a God-given gift, and make the best of it, make the most of it, and use it in the way that your Creator would like you to have.
Thank you, Miss South Africa. Thank you, ladies. We are even closer to finding out who will be the new Miss Universe. We help our judges in their final evaluation and to give our audience one more chance to make up their minds, we're going to treat everyone to another look at our five finalists. At this time, our celebrity panel, like our audience at home, can see close-ups of our contestants. Our special guest, Tom Jones, has chosen a most fitting song with which to serenade our ladies. My Kind of Girl.
She walks like an angel walks, and she talks like an angel talks, and her smile kinda like a pearl.
Wishes.
Good luck.
Thank you, Tom Jones. And you armchair judges, if you've been wavering throughout this pageant, picking one contestant as our winner and then switching to another, let me tell you that you're running out of time. Yes, sir. You better make up your mind right now.
I'll just bet no one is watching more closely to see who will be the next Miss Universe than the current Miss Universe, our beautiful Lorraine Downs. Lorraine, what are those five finalists thinking right now?
Well, they're all thrilled that they made it to the final five, but now comes the confidence. After all, these girls have won local pageants, national pageants. They made it to the semi-finalists, and now they're the finalists. So they're used to winning. But the eventual winner has no idea what it's going to be like.
What's going to be like, her victory tonight or her reign next year?
Both.
Have you anything to sum up about your year for us?
I guess the best way I would sum it up is that I have a 13-year-old sister whom I love very much. And if she wanted to enter the Miss Universe, I would encourage to you all I could.
That's beautiful. And everyone at the Miss Universe pageant has something in common with your little sister, because we're all very proud of you, Lorraine Downs, and the way you've worn the crown. You are a very special lady. Now, who will be the next to wear that crown? We're going to find that out right after this word from Joy.
It seems a year since I said to a lovely young lady from New Zealand, you are the new Miss Universe. But it must be a year, because she joins us now for her traditional walk and words of farewell. We all know that the new Miss Universe will find that her title carries even more prestige because it was worn so well by her predecessor. Ladies and gentlemen, Miss Universe 1983, Lorraine Downs.
Since I left New Zealand a year ago, I have been amazed at the wonder of the places I've been and the friendliness of the people I've met. To those people, thank you for the memories that remain within my heart. To the people of Miss Universe for their cooperation and help, and to my family and friends for their love and support, I send my deepest thanks. And to my successor, may it be all that you dream of and much, much more.
Thank you, Lorraine. This has been a wonderful pageant, and it seems only right to recognize the contribution of all of these young women. Now, they've come from all over the world, and both on and off the stage, they have brought credit to their countries. And ladies, we do indeed salute you. Our final computer tabulating results listing our four runners-up and our new Miss Universe are now ready. They've been reviewed by representatives of the international accounting firm of Ernst & Whinney, and Mr. John Labarca of that firm has them for me now. Thank you, John. Before I read it, let me say that any one of you five would make a wonderful Miss Universe. I shall begin with the fourth runner-up. The fourth runner-up is Miss Colombia. The third runner-up is Miss Philippines. Well done. The second runner-up is Miss Venezuela. Congratulations. Both of you step right down here, please. Now, one of you is about to become Miss Universe. The other is the first runner-up, an important position, because if for any reason Miss Universe cannot fulfill her obligations for the entire year, the first runner-up becomes Miss Universe. I shall read the name of the first runner-up and then Miss Universe. The first runner-up is Miss South Africa. Miss Sweden is Miss Universe. Congratulations. You are the new Miss Universe. You've won all the past awards and magnificent prizes, totaling more than $175,000. And now, as your predecessor, Lorraine Downs, reads the Miss Universe creed, I want you to take your flowers and step right out and show everyone how happy you are to be our new Miss Universe. This is Bob Barker thanking you for joining us and saying good night, everyone.
This is Joan Van Ark saying good night to everyone. Thank you for joining us on a very exciting evening. Good night, y'all. Congratulations to the new Miss Universe.
This program was pre-recorded.